So I get tons of emails every single day, press releases from different government agencies. And I have to say, when I saw this one this morning, I actually thought it was fake. I thought it was from The Onion. I thought it was satire. I get to what it was coming up. But let's just kind of review what's been going on in Baltimore over the last couple of years, if you will. All right, we've got, what, about 300 murders a year now. We've got problems with juvenile crime and carjacking. We have seven-year-olds who have been murdered riding in the backseat of cars in Baltimore. What else do we have going on? Well, we've got police corruption that is so outrageous, Hollywood probably would just laugh at you if you came with that plot and said, hey, let's talk about this gun trace task force. We've got schools that don't have heats. We've got schools where you literally have zero kids who have passed certain elements of the park tests. We even have rats in pastry displays throughout Baltimore, not to mention heroin and panhandlers. And having said all that, what is Baltimore announcing this morning? They're going to sue Big Oil. That's right. We're going after Big Oil. Getting them. All right. This is the press release that we received this morning. Baltimore announces action against fossil fuel companies to protect taxpayers, you, from the cost and consequences of climate change. What? Mayor Catherine Pugh in Baltimore, Maryland, will be joined by Baltimore City Solicitor Andre M. Davis to announce Baltimore's legal action against the top oil and gas companies on behalf of the citizens of Baltimore. The lawsuit cites damages associated with sea level rise and changes to the hydrologic cycle. I can't even say it. That include more frequent and severe heat waves, drought, and extreme precipitation events, all of which are caused by the company's products. So Big Oil is causing all these problems in the city, right? Obviously, clearly. So first of all, good luck with this lawsuit. And to be fair, Baltimore is not the first city to do this. There have been other cities in California, and New York has done it as well. But this is coming the day after a U.S. district judge said to New York, this is stupid. You can't do this. Throwing this out, this is something that is done at the federal level with policy. You can't sue them for climate change. It's impossible. Now, let's just take a minute and think about what would happen if they won. So if they won and all of these oil companies were forced to pay tens of millions of dollars to Baltimore and every other major city in the country, what would that do to them? Would it send them into bankruptcy? Would it be good for the country? Because guess what would happen? Other companies in other parts of the world would do better, which would not be good for the environment. And oh, by the way, who's forcing you to drive a car? Is the mayor driving a car every single day? Do we have city trucks that are run with gasoline? Yes. Do we have computers that use oil? Yes. All right. We use oil every single day and we need oil. All right. We got buses that use oil. So, I mean, this nonsense that they're going to sue Big Oil and take all this money that's causing all these problems is just kind of silly. But then I got to think, all right, so we've had recently, we're going to not necessarily ban, but we're going to say to parents, you're not going to be able to order a kid's menu without us giving you water or milk instead of Pepsi or a Coke product. We need the children to be healthier, right? Now you actually have to ask for the Coke, okay? We're gonna ban styrofoam. We're pretty soon going to ban plastic straws and all these things. Now, I've never been one to say you can't do other things while you have high crime or whatever. You can walk and chew gum at the same time. But these are the priorities for us right now. It seems kind of strange. And then if you really want to talk about pollution, and if you really want to talk about emissions into the air, what's the real big problem with that? Traffic, sitting in traffic, and when your car is just running and you're standing and you're stuck. And we have a city that tried to fix that problem by synchronizing the lights. And what happened? Ooh, it didn't work. It caused more problem. It caused more congestion. It caused more traffic and therefore more pollution. The city did that. Can we sue the city for suing Big Oil because we're stuck in traffic on a regular basis? This is just one thing that I have to say is the most idiotic thing that I've heard in a long time, going after them, knowing they're not going to win, knowing it's going nowhere, and all it will do is not save the taxpayers, but will cost the taxpayers. So we'll get into this Monday morning right here on WBAL News Radio 1090.